Speak Indo Podcast is a medium to think about life while learning about the Indonesian language and culture. Hi, I'm Natasha, the host of Speak Indo Podcast. The first part of the story will be narrated in the Indonesian language. The second part will be in English. The transcript is available on our blog, speakindo.life, and our YouTube, Speak Indo channel. Season 3, Episode 4, How Music Unites Us.
Pada tahun 2009, saya sendirian keliling Amerika Latin selama 6 bulan sebisa mungkin jalan darat naik bis umum. Naik bis antar kota di negara asing itu memang banyak suka dukanya. Sukanya karena jadi bisa mengenal sebuah negara dengan lebih baik lewat ketemu dengan orang-orang baru dan ngelihat pemandangan spektakuler. Dukanya, nah untuk yang satu ini, untung saya lahir dan besar di Indonesia, yang bikin saya lebih terbiasa dengan sikon transportasi umum yang bapuk dibanding turis dari negara maju. Ada kecoa atau serangga lain lewat di jendela? Biasa. Bis ngetem lulu, walau gondok, tapi juga biasa. Ada yang bawa hewan peliharaan ke dalam bis? Nggak masalah, asal saya nggak dipipisin aja. Berebut kursi di bis? Yang sudah pernah naik AirAsia lebih dari sekali pasti sudah handal urusan beginian. Supir nyetir ugal-ugalan, serasa balik di Jakarta, plus menavigasi badan supaya tidak jatuh pas nggak ke bagian tempat duduk ada seninya tersendiri. Pedagang asongan di bis? Terus terang, saya suka kagum dengan barang-barang yang dijual di dalam transportasi umum. Kalau koran, minuman, dan makanan kecil mah standar ya, tapi banyak dagangan lain suka bikin garuk-garuk kepala. Kadang, satu orang jualan berbagai jenis produk, mulai dari buku anak-anak sampai bibit tanaman. Yang paling pol waktu di Ekuador adalah pedagang yang menjual obat yang katanya bisa menyembuhkan segala penyakit yang berhubungan dengan performa seks pria. Sales pitch-nya garing, tapi berapi-api dan persuasif. Bapak-bapak, ada yang bermasalah di tempat tidur? Bagus, tidak ada anak kecil di sini. Jadi saya bisa teruskan. Ibu-ibu, jangan mengacuhkan omongan saya ini ya. Mungkin sekarang belum ada masalah, tapi nanti bisa terjadi pada suami Anda. Lalu pedagang, seperti juga pedagang yang lain, bakal membagikan produk yang dijual ke semua penumpang. Jualan diteruskan sementara penumpang atau calon konsumen mengamat-amati produknya, lalu dia akan keliling bis lagi untuk mengambil kembali barang yang tidak laku. Yang minat beli ya saat itu bayar. Lalu bagaimana dengan musik yang diputar supir? Kalau di Indonesia genre yang populer adalah dangdut koplo, sepanjang Amerika Latin kecuali Uruguay, musik favorit supir dan kenek bis antar kota adalah reggaeton dan ballad cengeng, diputar dengan volume yang menggelegar. Dua-duanya bikin bete. Apa itu reggaeton? Ada yang bilang reggaeton itu hip-hop Latin. Ada yang bilang kombinasi antara reggae dan hip-hop. Singkat kata, dangdut Latin. Memasuki bulan kedua dari perjalanan 6 bulan naik bis, tanda kutip menikmati suguhan musik bis dengan volume tinggi, dikasih dengar pidato undang-undang ketenaga kerjaan pun saya bakal rela. Sumpah. Nah, bayangkan betapa girangnya saya waktu kenek bis di Kuba trayek Santiago menuju Camagui yang berangkat jam 10 malam, memasang DVD, bajakan tentunya, yang isinya konser musik top 40 era 70-an, Bee Gees, Boney M, Barry White. Pak kenek memilih Bee Gees. Terima kasih Tuhan! Saat Robin Gibb mulai melantunkan To Love Somebody, saya pun langsung ikut nyanyi dengan pelan dan malu-malu ketika tiba-tiba supir nimbrung dengan kencang, "You don't know what it's like." Dan dengan demikian, di jalanan nan gelap antah berantah entah di mana, seorang turis Indonesia dan supir bis Kuba kemudian nyanyi bareng mengiringi trio Gibb dari Australia. Malam itu, saya tidur nyenyak di bis.
The next one will be the English version of the story. In 2009, Leah took a solo trip across Latin America for 6 months, where as much as possible, she took the land route using a public bus. Taking a local intercity bus in a foreign land has its own ups and downs. The ups are mainly due to the experience of knowing a country a bit better through meeting new people and seeing spectacular views along the way. The down part? For this, Leah is grateful for being born and raised in Indonesia, where she had already been accustomed to the situation and conditions of poor public transportation if compared to a tourist coming from a developed country. Cockroaches and other insects crawling on the window? Already used to it. The bus stopping frequently to wait for sufficient numbers of passengers? Annoying, but again, already used to it. People bringing their pets on the bus? No problem, as long as they don't urinate on her. Fighting for seats on the bus? Anyone who has flown with AirAsia, a low-cost carrier, more than once would already be an expert in this. Driver driving recklessly? It feels just like being in Jakarta. Plus, there is a certain art in the capability of navigating your body so that you don't fall when you don't manage to get a seat. Hawkers and vendors on the bus? In all honesty, Leah often admired all the things that are being sold in public transportation. If it's just newspapers, drinks, or snacks, those are pretty standard stuff. However, many other merchandise can make one scratch one's head. Sometimes, one trader will try to sell many different products, from children's books to plant seeds. The most over-the-top experience was in Ecuador, when a trader was trying to sell a medicine he claimed could cure all types of illnesses related to the male sex performance. The sales pitch was corny, yet fiery and persuasive. He was asking the male passengers whether they had any sex problems, and felt free to ask this as there were no children present on the bus. He also informed the women that they should not ignore this, as one day their husbands might experience this problem. Then, as what all the hawkers always did, he distributed his products to all of the passengers. He kept on promoting the products while the passengers or potential buyers examined the products. Then he would go around the bus to pick up the unbought items. Interested buyers would pay on the spot. What about the music played by the bus driver? In Indonesia, the most popular genre is dangdut koplo. Indonesian music, which is influenced by Arabic and Hindi-style music, filled with the beat of a small drum. All across Latin America, except for Uruguay, the favorite music of intercity bus drivers and their assistants is reggaeton and sappy ballads, played to the maximum volume. Both of them are quite aggravating for Leah. What is reggaeton? Some say that reggaeton is Latin hip-hop. Some say that it is a combination of reggae and hip-hop. In short, Latin dangdut. Entering the second month of the six-month bus journey, after enjoying the presentation of bus music played to the maximum volume, Leah swore that she would welcome listening to even a speech on the labor laws. Imagine how happy Leah was when the assistant driver on the bus in Cuba, en route from Santiago to Camagüey, leaving at 10 p.m., played a DVD, pirated of course, which contents were top 40 music concerts of the 70s era. Bee Gees, Bonnie M., Barry White. The assistant chose Bee Gees. Thank the Lord. When Robin Gibb started to sing To Love Somebody, Leah immediately sang as well, softly and shyly, when suddenly the driver joined in loudly. You don't know what it's like. With that, on a dark road in the middle of nowhere, an Indonesian tourist and a Cuban bus driver joined forces, singing together, accompanying the Gibb brothers from Australia. That night, Leah slept soundly in the bus. This is a story from Rusmailia Lenggogeni, who is originally from Jakarta, Indonesia. She currently resides in Jakarta and works as a writer and an advertising creative director. Her book, titled Bus Diaries, Jurnal Perjalanan Amerika Latin, or Bus Diaries, a Latin America travel journal, can be purchased through Gramedia at ebooks.gramedia.com/id/bus-diaries. The info is also available in our blog.
As As this is one of our editions, as we are still in the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic, we'd like to extend our deep condolences to those who have lost their loved ones. This is definitely a very difficult time for everyone, and we can only hope that soon we can all heal as nature flourishes. Probably one day when we look back, we learn that how valuable is the time that we have to hug our loved ones, to be kind to our fellow humans, and to thank the sun for shining upon us.
I'm Natasha, your host of Speak Indo Podcast, and we would like to thank our guest speakers for sharing their story. If you like the story, please share it with your friends and family. The transcript of the story is available at our blog speakindo.life and our YouTube Speak Indo channel. You can subscribe to our channel so that you won't miss any upcoming episodes. These are our stories. What is yours?